All right, we'll go that way.
There does seem to be a lot more people here than the previous year. Maybe people in the city trying to have fun.
Check that out.
We do have celebrities in multiple aisles here, so make sure you don't miss your favorite celebrity.
Which way you wanna go?
I don't know.
Where's Megan and Cameron? Oh, look at the little gremlins. Little Shop of Horrors, baby. Where?
Ah, that's funny.
Baby, look at these masks. Look at that one. Guys, we're at Scarefest in Kentucky. I'm not saying anything. I want y'all to see some things, but it's really crowded here. Okay, now what?
Let's just stop here. Stop here for a second.
A lot of people.
And like, dude was like this.
Yeah. We got PJ Stars. Come on up.
All right, table fans, let's go.
Okay.
Dave Sheridan, come on up.
I have not seen any of them. Where are they?
Megan heading stop.
Look for a yellow cat.
There's a live wolf over there.
Yeah, that's alive.
I want to see. Can I show your wolf on TikTok? Can I show your wolf on TikTok? Okay. Look, guys. It's a live wolf. I thought it was stuffed until it moved. Oh. Cameron has got to see that. Look at all the jewelry, guys. Did you make all this? Oh. Zoom in on pretty. Does he or she have a name?
It's Nayeli.
Huh?
Nayeli.
Nayeli.
We'll look back.
With bones. Okay. Thank you.
Go look at my camera. It was on the
We'll look back when we find it.
Bro. Okay. That was nice of him. He let me put his wolf on TikTok. There's the Crypt Keeper guy. Oh my gosh, look at their costumes from Beetlejuice. Look at your costumes from Beetlejuice.
I saw a Jared.
Blue light on camera. Guys, I can't show y'all some things because some things cost money and people don't want me putting a camera on them. But I'll show y'all what I can. We're at Scarefest in Kentucky.
I don't know Chucky doll.
I found them way cheaper than that on eBay. Look at all the Chucky dolls, guys.
I've noticed. I've seen it from way over there.
Yeah. I didn't take it.
$600?
Yeah. That is crazy. Sorry, guys. I don't want to show people's faces when I'm walking through here. I've got to be careful because some people don't like you to film. But we are at Scarefest in Kentucky. It is so crowded. Look up there, guys. I don't know if y'all can. Let me see if I can.
I think we're going to separate from you.
Honey, what are you doing? Okay, they're separating from us because we're making too many turns. Yeah, everybody's got phones.
Trying to get through this thing.
Oh, those are cool. Is it okay if I show your stuff on TikTok?
Oh, sure is.
Okay. Did you make all this?
I sure did.
This is beautiful. You did good. Look at all the collars, chokers, guys. Ooh, I love that. The evil eye. Thank you.
How's it going?
Good, how are you?
Real paranormal?
Yes.
I've worked with Ed Lorraine Warren since 1990.
Ooh.
This is the most terrifying case I've ever investigated in 32 years, and I recreated it in a horror format like you're reading a Stephen King book.
Oh, that's
and
cool.
It happens just days before Halloween.
That's awesome.
So I'm doing autographed signed copies with a free print. Bishop James Long made the books required to be for his demonology
I remember
class.
Him. I'm recording on TikTok. Is this okay?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Let me show you.
Bishop James Long made my books required reading for his demonology class.
Okay.
He's a wonderful friend. He gave me a great write-up. So I encourage everybody to go to his demonology class and sign up. And this is the most terrifying case that I've ever investigated in 32 years, and I recreated it in a cinematic horror format like you're reading a Stephen King book.
Uh-huh.
And the most common comments were, I could not put the book down, but I couldn't read it at night. And it happens just days before Halloween, and it involves a Ouija board used by three 16-year-old boys.
Uh-huh.
And after the case was resolved, they came back for payback, and that's why it's a case of retribution on a scale we've never experienced before. So there's a separate volume, and I actually sent this PDF to Bishop Long before I released the book, and I said I'm really hesitant to release it because of the sexual nature of the incubus and succubus attacks that take place. And he read it from page one to the end, and he said you have to release it because people need to know this is real. And it's rare, but it's real, and it's awful that happened. What happened to these kids? So I traveled the country warning kids about Ouija board use and why they should be avoided at all costs because they're not a game.
Oh, no, no.
And they cause more problems for everybody than you can even imagine, and more problems for us because we have so many more potent things to deal with.
Oh, yeah.
To expel. So please don't use Ouija boards. And
Here's his book. Let's see your book.
Dark Siege, A Connecticut Family's Nightmare. Dark Siege 2, The Nightmare Returns, and it's the most terrifying, fascinating case I've ever investigated in 32 years. I worked with Ed Maureen Warren starting in 1990 when I was in college. I wrote a column called Hauntings for the Sacred Heart University Spectrum newspaper, chronicling the cases that we were investigating together. And I couldn't have asked for two better teachers and mentors, and it was a privilege and an honor to work with both Ed and Lorraine simultaneously. My next book that's being released is called The Demon of Daybreak Farm, and it's about a case that we all investigated together in Vermont, and it was mind-blowing.
Okay, guys, this is in Kentucky at Monster Fest.
Scarefest.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Look at that. That's cool. Okay, I got something's up with my phone. I got to make sure I'm still on my live here. Sorry guys, something's up with my phone. Get the Charles Manson shirt. Excuse me. I've got to see if I'm still on my live. How are you going, baby? Oh, they got the nightmare house. Yeah, Freddy Krueger.